Hi, Dr. Saxena here, and talking about some of the things which I've been talking on different platforms, and this is all we are trying to work on. What are the things which can be done in this present pandemic, and what are the various ways we can go through? We are trying to work on some areas where there is a kind of this one. Everyone is not able to get into a hospital because of some various reasons. Some people are not finding oxygen cylinders and all that. In that scenario, what are the things which as doctors like us working in this field for a quite long time, what I believe is a simple thing called a vitamin therapy, which is called vitamin C. Let's explore what exactly is this vitamin C. To start with, this using vitamin C to treat viruses is not a novel idea. In fact, a scientific paper published in way back in 1935 found that extremely small amounts of vitamin C has the ability to inactivate diphtheria toxin in vitro and in vivo. Because of this revolutionary findings, a study was conducted to see what the results would be on poliomyelitis virus. That time it was quite big, poliomyelitis was the big picture. Then it was found there was some kind of work which was done, and they showed high dose vitamin C in the form of intravenous. They were able to treat the poliomyelitis also. Later, there was Hemina, which reported a new coronavirus way back in 2003, which was the causative factor for the SARS. SARS was severe acute respiratory syndrome. This happened in 2003. Now we are dealing with a new coronavirus, not new coronavirus, we are dealing with COVID-19, what is being post-Wuhan. At that time in 2003, there were no treatment for SARS. Based on the available research, it was known that vitamin C was beneficial to the immune system by reducing respiratory infections and may support pneumonia patients. So, under certain circumstances, this vitamin C can assist reducing lower respiratory infections, and it deserved further investigations. And it was in 2017, it was Fowler, their case presented, these people presented the first case, virus-induced respiratory distress, ARDS, caused by enterovirus, rhinovirus respiratory infection, that used high-dose vitamin C as a treatment. From their clinical experience, what they did was, they used IV vitamin C to treat acute sepsis. They used the same intervention for a 20-year-old previously healthy female who got that entero or rhinovirus, which was not, that quickly became ARDS. They reported in treating sepsis that high dose of vitamin C not only reduced multi-organ injury, but also inflammatory biomarkers levels also. After a 12-day hospital stay and the follow-up visit 1 month later, the patient completely recovered without lung damage, suggesting larger trials utilizing IV vitamin C should be conducted to treat that ARDS. ARDS is that kind of bright picture over the lungs. Normally, lungs has got black shadows in the X-ray, whereas when you have got ARDS, everything becomes opaque, white, because a lot of secretions are there in the lungs. So the major kind of struggle which we have been seeing in the ICUs, people putting on the mechanical ventilator, ECMO and all that, is purely to combat that ARDS. Later, this COVID-19, which was first reported in Wuhan, ARDS was the main component of the COVID. Which was deadly due to the cellular injury and the organ failure. Studies have shown high-dose oral vitamin C guards against viral infections. IV vitamin C as well as high dose of oral vitamin C have presented without serious side effects. There were the studies which conducted, they showed high dose of vitamin C intravenous as well as oral and without any serious side effects. 50 moderate to severe COVID-19 patients were received high dose vitamin C in China. Doses fluctuated between 10 grams and 20 grams per day, administered over a period of 8 to 10 hours, with high doses of vitamin C being given to the critical patients. It went further also. We were discussing with Ian Brighthope another webinar, and he said he has gone up to 100 very fast. There is another doctor from Mumbai, he also talks about not to wait by giving that minuscule doses. He wants to step up immediately to 25 grams vitamin C and go ahead with that. This study, which was done in Wuhan, at this 20 to 20 grams and all that, all these patients' oxygenation levels improved, and all of them were eventually cured and released. The expert from panel from NIH stated that high-dose vitamin C is a safe and effective treatment without serious side effects. With its known safety record, as well as other antioxidants, may mitigate COVID-19-associated ARDS. That is our concern. Moretti et al. In 2020 reported efficacy of IV vitamin C to treat COVID-19 virus. Because of the current controversy of using antiviral treatments that were developed for other diseases to treat that new virus. Vitamin C, I can always tell you, I try to check for something like G6PD, and G6PD, once it is normal, you can always give safe, there are no problems which occur. The people who have low G6PD, the people who are deficiency of this enzyme called glucose-6-phosphodehydrogenase, where we are not able to give high dose of vitamin C, those people we try to exclude from our cases. We had a case study of 64-year-old female who came with flu-like symptoms. Some of the symptoms included mild headache, conjunctivitis, fever, joint pain, malaise, muscle aches and all that. So I thought, let me go for this IV vitamin C. We were waiting for the results to come and all that. So we were able to go for vitamin C. IVs give that phenomenal 30 to 40 times, 30 to 70 times more than the oral things in treating things which come in the blood, and that helps in treating the virus. Due to this antiviral and antioxidant properties of vitamin C, how the patient was tested, this was in the doses given where it was G6PD negative, and we started 25 grams and upping the 25 grams for 3 consecutive days, and within 24 hours the symptoms have substantially improved. The third day were gone totally, and this was established that not just my studies, there are people who has done a lot of studies, Marcia Vega et al. They have done 25 to 50 grams of vitamin C, along with they have used hydrogen peroxide also. I can give a lot of literature talking about this particular stuff, scurvy and vitamin C food, and lot of papers are presented, and there is a big number of data we have. Supplemental ascorbate in the supportive treatment of cancer, it can be used for in response to cancer therapy. So big things on this particular stuff, and this is how we try to work it out by strategizing, giving this vitamin C, high dose vitamin C, and I believe we have a good marker in giving this vitamin C, and I just want to not take chances and all that. Even if you have got minimal symptoms and all that, try to look into the simple things like adjunct measures, and try to look into the high dose vitamin C IV dose. It will help you in a phenomenal way, and it will absolutely stop you into getting into problems. Thank you.